Hi, my name is Lauren and I work at the Texas Water Development Board, where my job is to help build and maintain a system of weather stations that are scattered all across the state. These stations are taking real-time data on things like barometric pressure, rainfall, temperature, and wind speed and wind direction, as well as a bunch of other variables. We do this work so that Texans, like yourself, can always know what's going on in their area when you visit texmesonet.org. Now, you don't always need a team of meteorologists or a bunch of fancy equipment to know what's going on in your own backyard. You can actually take some household items that you may already have and make some of these things yourself. So that's what we're gonna do today. So for our quickest weather instrument that we're gonna make, we're going to make a rain gauge. You just need three things: a clear jar, preferably with straight edges, a marker, a permanent marker, and a ruler. And really, this is gonna be so quick. I'm gonna lay down my jar, do it however is comfortable. And I'm gonna take my ruler to make some tick marks at every inch on the jar. I'm just gonna draw or write straight on my jar, but you could use masking tape to help you write on the jar or whatever you want, be creative. So I'm gonna make a 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch, 4 inch, and 5 inch. Just go as high up as you can. I'm also gonna make marks at the halfway points. So 0.5 inches, 1.5 inches, 2.5, 3.5, and 4.5. All right, my marks are made. Now, I think probably the hardest part of this project is finding the right jar for it. Because you kind of want those straight edges. That's gonna help you get a more accurate measurement in the end. So you can find a plastic bottle at home and maybe cut off the top if you see that it has a flat bottom and straight edges. Just look around, check out the recycling, whatever might be in there. Oops, accidentally wrote 1 inch at the top. That's not right. And I'm just gonna mark them off. Turn my 1 inch into a 5 inch. And that's it. You're gonna set this outside in an area without any cover above it, so no awnings or trees preferably. And that's really it. All you have to do is wait for some rain to fall and go outside after the rain and see how much water has collected in your bottle. That's it, pretty easy.